George talked about wanting to have a large chrome ship, very Art Deco-ish, fast-looking form. And we had some SR-71 Blackbird model kits. We were taking them and cutting off the noses and putting the bodies together and experimenting with that. And George saw the box and said, do that. And if you look at it, you can plainly see that it's inspired by the SR-71. A concept model, there was a small foam one built that was maybe 5-6 inches long to get the basic buy-off on proportion shape, just to see if everybody was on the same page. That got approved and then went to a larger model that was about maybe a little over 2 feet long. And that was fully detailed, had these long spikes coming off the back of it, and we had it sent it out and had it chromed. Chrome's really a difficult thing because the full-size model we built was 11 feet long. We're trying to figure out how we're going to get that kind of surface on it. There wasn't a tank big enough to chemically plate it or to vacuum plate it. So Mylar was the selection we came up with, and they did some tests with a couple of the Nabu fighters and took some 2-inch Mylar tape and just kind of stuck it everywhere. And if you look at them up close, they're really crude, but on film it looks great.
At the moment, we're finding problems with the adhesive. However, we sure we'll be able to achieve what they want.
Our model is going to be scrutinized much more closely. So we went to a heavier Mylar from 3M that was, I think, 30 inches wide. The Mylar kind of only wants to go in one direction. It doesn't like compound curves. If you tried to put it over a dome, it wouldn't work. On the Queen ship, there was enough of a compound curve to it that we'd come back in the mornings and the Mylar would have peeled symmetrically on it and create these little puckers. And so each day we would cut those to relieve the structure of it.
Symmetry by hand is extremely difficult, if not impossible, to do. By using 3D models and having a CNC machine sculpted out, one thing that's cool about it is you can actually just make half the ship and then mirror image it and you get exact duplicate mirror image. We actually shot it up on the roof of the ILM shooting stage so that we wouldn't get any phone poles and things. And so in the background was actually the sky of the Bay Area. The camera crews, they had to cover their areas up so that you wouldn't see the camera reflected into it.
To see it go from a concept painting and then see scenes with the actors in Tunisia with a ramp and then to composite that with our miniature looks pretty amazing. It's always interesting when you combine all those elements and this magic happens where it suddenly becomes this, you know, 200-foot-long spaceship and people running out of the door and you know, you realize it was just shot up on top of the main stage on a tabletop.